Welcome to Go Get It. Today we are going to see View Serializable Schedules. To know about Conflict Serializable Schedule, I would strongly recommend to refer the video session mentioned in the description of this video. So View Serializable Schedule. Its definition says that any given concurrent schedule is said to be a view serializable schedule if and only if it is view equivalent to one of the possible serial schedule. We will be shortly noticing what is view equivalence. But before we proceed further, I would like to make a note here that determining whether a given schedule is view serializable schedule or not, that problem or that solution comes under NP-complete problem. You must have heard about this NP-completeness in theory of computation. So that's a NP-complete problem. So in generally, you will find that in view serializable schedule some set of transaction, it will be difficult to determine whether it is view serializable schedule or not, and that's why it falls under NP-complete problem. So to explain view equivalence, I have given here some, we'll consider with a problem here. So we'll consider one thing, just a second. I'll mark it. So you can notice we have given schedule. So this is S1 and the equivalent serial schedule is S2. So this is nothing but the equivalent serial schedule what we have assumed here. This is a consideration we have considered. Consider this as a respective serial schedule of the given concurrent schedule. So T1, T2, T3. This is the given concurrent schedule. This is nothing but the concurrent schedule, and this is the serial schedule. There are possible, as in the previous video session we have discussed, that as there are three transactions T1, T2 and T3 in the schedule, so there is a possibility there are 2 raised to 3 equals to 8 possible serial schedules are there. So we have assumed T2, T3, T1 because we cannot work on all the possible 8 solutions, so that's why it falls under NP-complete problem also. So start with the basic condition in view equivalence. So the definition of view equivalence says that any given two schedules S1 and S2 are said to be view equivalent to each other if and only if these following points are satisfied. So the first point is initial reads. So what does this initial reads mean? So you can notice here that for S1, the initial read are performed on T3 and T1 on item X. So these are the initial reads performed here. I cannot count this Rx as initial read because before Rx was performed from T1, T3 has already written something on Wx. That's why this read of X is nothing but an updated value of X, which is updated by transaction T3. And that's why this does not come under the initial read category. So you can notice here T3 and T2 are performing the initial read in S1. And as the view serializable schedules definition says that it should be view equivalent to one of the possible serial schedule. So for us, for here, the given S2 is a serial schedule. And here also you can notice that for T2 and T3, the initial reads are performed. So the first condition is satisfied here. So I hope you are with me with for initial reads. What does this initial reads means? Now the second condition is write and read conflict. So in the given schedule, if any schedule is having write read conflict, so for example in S1 we have a write read conflict, so the same write read conflict and the same number of write read conflict should exist in S2 also in the same order. So you can notice here we have Wx Rx write read conflict in the same order from T3 to T1. Here also it is from T3 to T1. So this is also satisfied. And the final condition is the final writes. Final write operation. So whatever the final write operations are performed here, Say for example in this schedule S1, so it says that the transactions which are performing the final writes on the data item. So the transactions which are perform the final write on the data item from schedule S1 are supposed to perform the final writes on the respective data item in the schedule S2. So here you can see in S1 WX or the write operation, the final write operation in this complete schedule was performed by T1, and in S2 also the final write was performed by T1 itself. So this is also satisfied, and as these three, all the three conditions are satisfied, we can say that it is view serializable schedule. This is view serializable schedule. And one more worth noting point is here, you can note this graph, this will be very useful in exam point of view. So this block denotes view serializable, this denotes conflict serializable. So this is nothing but these are the all schedules. So here, from this given set diagram, you can see, you can directly say that any conflict serializable schedule is a view serializable schedule. But any view serializable schedule does not necessarily be conflict schedule. So I hope you are with me. This diagram is very helpful from exam point of view. So now let's move to our one more example we'll see here. So this example, we need to determine whether the given schedule is view serializable schedule or not. So this is the given S1, and this are the two possible. So you can notice here we have T1 and T2, so 2 raised to 1. So you can see T1, T2, T2, T1, these are the two possible schedules possible. So S2 and S3. So S2 and S3 are the possible schedules, T1, T2, T2, T1. So you can, the very first condition, what it says that initial read. So initial read operation in case of S1, the initial read was performed by T1 and T2. But in case of T1 to T2 serial schedule, you can say the initial read was performed by T1. Okay, this is satisfied. But in case of T2, you will say that, yeah, here also our reading operation is performed. But you can notice here, before this read operation was performed, one write operation performed by T1, and that shows that this read operation is performed on a updated value of A. So this set of transaction violates the very first condition of initial read. This was with the case of S2. Let's consider the another possible serial schedule, that is T2 to T1. Here again I have noted only the possibilities. So again, read operation is performed here, initial read, here also initial read. But as this read operation was performed after the write operation was performed by T2. So again, this is violating the initial read condition. So we can directly say that as this initial read condition is not satisfied, this is not view serializable. This is not a view serializable schedule. So I hope you are with me. This example says that this is not a view serializable schedule. And the last example, I'm not going to solve this question. This is, you have to solve this question for your practice. But for your ease, I'm giving you the answer here. So the answer to this question, and the question was, you have to determine whether it is a conflict view serializable, conflict serializable, third is both, and fourth is none of the above. So the answer is nothing but both. So the solution I'm leaving it to the viewer. So the answer is this one. So for any demands, please mail us at this email ID, demand@gogateiit.com. Thanks for listening. Have a great day.